Planet Earth is complex, and we rely on mathematics to unlock its mysteries. It is integral in both shaping our world and understanding it. In conjunction with researchers in Australia and overseas, CSIRO is using mathematical sciences to explore the complex nature of Alzheimer's disease and strive to reveal the secrets surrounding its biological triggers.
CSIRO's goal is to delay the onset of Alzheimer's by 5 years by the time we hit 2020.
Hundreds of thousands of Australians suffer from Alzheimer's disease, and as our population ages, numbers will increase, putting a huge burden on our healthcare services and families. CSIRO is using statistics to develop a screening test for the early detection of Alzheimer's disease.
Alzheimer's disease is the leading cause of dementia, and it's about 50 to 80% of all dementia cases are made up from Alzheimer's disease.
And what happens?
So that's a cross-sectional if you sort of... Currently, there's 250,000 Australians suffering from dementia, and that's set to increase to nearly 1 million by the time we hit 2050.
Alzheimer's is triggered by a build-up of amyloid beta levels, which become abnormal around 17 years before the onset of dementia.
Amyloid beta is really the first phase of that we can detect in Alzheimer's disease. It's the earliest biomarker we can pick up. We detect it as a build-up of this protein that misfolds in the brain and builds up as plaques in the brain very early in disease.
It is critical that this build-up is detected early if therapies are to be developed to slow or alter the progression of the disease.
And because people have got Alzheimer's disease...
This is where the maths comes in.
Maths plays a very important role in our image analysis work for the ABLE study. If you could understand, a human brain is a very complex structure. It's convoluted and its surfaces are very different. So the mathematicians deconstruct that and make it into an interpretable sphere, finite volume that they can analyse.
As part of the Australian Imaging, Biomarkers and Lifestyle Study of Ageing, or ABLE, CSIRO is using sophisticated mathematical models for some complex analysis.
We looked at blood biomarkers as well as some cognitive testing and some demographic information. The panel that we ended up with is based on 7 markers taken from the blood, as well as age and 1 cognitive test.
Using the data from 273 patients, 9 out of a possible 300 biomarkers were isolated that will hopefully give doctors 8 to 10 years' notice of the onset of the disease.
What early detection does at the moment is provide us with opportunities to intervene over the time course of the disease.
And using CSIRO's statistical expertise, a solution to early detection could be achieved.
If you want to pull together the biomarker blood panels and pull together the rest of the data with that, it wouldn't be possible without the maths.
Australia's ageing population means the number of people suffering from dementia is one of the fastest growing major diseases, overtaking coronary heart disease. By the 2060s, spending on dementia will outstrip all other health conditions. The valuable work by the CSIRO team could delay the onset of Alzheimer's by 5 years, nearly halving the cost of dementia to our society.
The cost of Alzheimer's is currently at 1% of gross domestic product. So with this increasing number of cases, that's going to be crippling on our healthcare system, as well as on carers and family members. So this is a real challenge for Australia.
What we're hoping to do in earlier stages is to have a blood biomarker screen that is really going to be able to pick out using proteins, lipids, metals in bloods, metabolites such as sugars, etc. A combination of those which are going to provide us with a signature, if you like, a bit like cholesterol is for heart disease.
This offers the researchers at CSIRO opportunities to go further into intervention trials and also look at lifestyle strategies that may be protective to Alzheimer's disease.
These are the sorts of things that we have, we can tease out through the statistical analysis that we can do through the longitudinal studies of that we're undertaking within the ABLE cohort.
As you can see,
continuing this research in early detection is critical in addressing the challenge of this debilitating disease.
That's amazing.
Using statistics and mathematical modelling will be crucial in finding solutions.
By your mid-80s, 50% of people have some amyloid build-up in their brain. So actually, if we live long enough, we're going to be all, or a large percentage of us are going to be at risk for Alzheimer's disease.